great, but what? They've got a get-right game, right? They haven't lost to the Lions at home since 1991. No Eddie Lacy in this game, inactive throwing injury. But this Packers offense, boy, since week four, they really struggled. They're the bottom of the league in yards per game, passing yards per game, third down conversion percentage, and they struggled again.
Protecting Aaron Rodgers has been a problem, but there's been some times he's had time, he just can't get comfortable in the pocket and find anybody down the field.
Sacked there by Caron Reed. Packers were just 3 of 9 on third down in the first half. Rodgers, Kyle there, quick 2-yard gain. Kind of hobbling a little bit. Yeah, take a look at that left foot. Third quarter, opening kickoff. This was tied at 3.5. Speaking of barn burners. How about Amir Abdullah? Boy, after that week one run we saw against the Chargers, hadn't really heard from Amir except for some fumbles. And, well, he comes up with a huge kickoff return.
Big play for them. He did that a lot at Nebraska. I remember going to watch him in a bowl game. They start every possession about the 40 to 50 yard line because of his kickoff return.
If he can just hold on to that ball when he gets in on offense, he could be a real threat.
3 plays later, Matt Stafford rolling right finds Brandon Pettigrew. Hey, now, I need Eric Ebron. But the other Lions first round draft
pick middle plan
years ago. So Matt Prater on to kick the extra point. Well, Matt Prater is perfect on field goals this year. Not as much, that is his second extra point miss of the season. So here we go. Lions up 12-3. Under eight to play in the game. Rodgers, 3rd and 2, looking deep.
You know, he had a lot of time there. You know, obviously got the pass interference call.
All right, so here, no, Packers
against
call.
Them. Yeah,
yeah, for
them.
Holding. Lions would decline the penalty initially. Packers then look like they're going for it on 4th and 2. Then Chip Call says, no, let's enforce it. 3rd and 12 then. Aaron Rodgers, boy, as he's getting hit, that's
an
impressive
throw. I mean, that's an ill-advised throw. 9 times out of 10, whoever you have at quarterback doing that, you would tell them not to do it. But Aaron Rodgers, he's Aaron Rodgers.
Finds Cobb, gain of 20. 6 plays later, Rodgers to Rodgers. Aaron to Richard. And the Packers now down a deuce, 12-10. Next Lions possession, under 3 minutes to play. Stafford to Golden Tate, who refuses to go down.
Oh,
look at the block by Pettigrew downfield.
You got to bring your feet. They have 3 guys leave their feet and try and bring him down. Golden Tate is too strong for that. You got to bring your feet on contact.
All right, so Tate. 2 plays later, setting up Stafford. Here's Aaron Rodgers, can do nothing but watch, along with McCarthy. Stafford to Lance Moore. Bounce around the league.
The problem with bad teams are that every once in a while, they can play a good game. There's some talent on the Missouri team.
Under 2 minutes to play, 18-10. You think with the extra point, 9-point game, it's over?
Not so fast.
Great. Misses his second.
Did I tell you that bad teams find a way to lose games?
Well, the Lions were trying to find a way. 18-10, so Packers with a chance to tie it with a touchdown or 2-point conversion. Looks like James Starks, though, is going to give it up. Fumbles, picked up by Isa Abdul-Qudus. And it looks like the Lions might just seal victory here, but hang on.
So you have the missed PAT. Now you have a fumble that's going to get called back. It just felt like, okay, the Packers don't have these breaks.
You're
another
track,
chance.
Right? Yep. Another shot. All right. So here we go. 1:30 to play. Rodgers back to Starks. Convoy in front. And Starks, big gainer in the Lions territory across the 50 on the screen pass. Time not really an issue here. They had timeouts. 40 seconds on the clock. 2nd and 10. Rodgers looking for Rodgers. And we've got a flag. Not on Tahir Whitehead as he was guarding Richard Rodgers, but on Ziggy Ansah for roughing the passer.
Yeah, went low. You go down by the knees. They're going to call it every time.
And they do here. So fresh set of downs now for Rodgers and the Packers. 36 seconds on the clock. Rodgers, 1st and 10. Got it. So now needing just a 2-point conversion after the touchdown to tie this thing. Rodgers pressured. Devontae Adams cannot come up with it. Preston Buckner signed on Saturday. Comes up with a big play on Sunday.
What a nice play on the ball of Adams.
And Rodgers.
So
like,
it's over finally.
Over.
So it's over. No. It's not more. No, it's not over yet.
Onside kick coming for the Packers. Nice one by Mason Crosby. What you got?
Wait.
Calvin Johnson.
That's Calvin Johnson that went up and
grabbed
the ball.
This is Megatron. Remember, go back to the Seattle game. Okay, now this is the script again. Calvin Johnson has the big blunder at the end of the game. Costs a lot of money.
And Calvin can't come up with the onside recovery. Demaryius Randle picks it up for the Packers.
You're Calvin Johnson. How do you drop the ball?
3rd and 10 for midfield. Rodgers to Davante Adams.
Oh, no. It's going to have to lay on top of it.
Yeah.
As much time as possible.
You only need 3 points.
Their timeout.
Packers
only need 3 points.
And they'll get a little more yardage here. So Mason Crosby from 52, but it is blocked. Jason Jones gets a hand on it.
In Lambeau.
And somehow.
In Lambeau.
The Lions winners in Lambeau for the first time since 1991.
CNC Music Factory?
I believe
was
so.
All
are you
going to
do this
right?
I'm not going to do it.
Come on.
I'm not going to do it. No. I'm not going to do it.
A little snap. You want to give me a little snap?
No.
Come on.
I will not.
The Lions have finally won at Lambeau for the first time since 1991.
Look at that tight control.
There it is.